For this problem, you are asked to verify a set of blinded messages, where blinded message B equals the original message M times R, a random nonce raised to the power E, mod N. And so the question is, given the random nonce R, how do we get M from B? There are two very similar ways to accomplish this, and I'll talk about both of them. In the first way, the first step is to calculate the inverse of R mod N. And I'd like to talk for a second about what this means and how to calculate it. So in normal arithmetic, not modular, finding the inverse is easy. We can just divide by R. As a simple example, if we have 3x equals y, we can find x by dividing by 3. But with modular arithmetic, this doesn't work. Taking our same example, 3x equals y mod 5, and set y equals 2. If we just divide, we get x equals 2/3, which doesn't make sense. X has to be an integer. It turns out the answer is actually 4. Because 3 times 4 is 12, and 12 mod 5 is 2. And so what we need to find is some z such that 3 times z is congruent to 1 mod 5. And it's fairly easy to see that z equals 2 accomplishes this. 3 times 2 is 6, 6 is 1 mod 5. So going back up to our original problem, we can solve 3x is congruent to y mod 5 for x by writing x is congruent to 2y mod 5. So if y equals 2, x is 2 times 2, which is 4. And for mod 5, here are all the inverses. 1 times 1 equals 1, 2 times 3 equals 6, which is congruent to 1, 3 times 2 equals 6, which is congruent to 1, and 4 times 4 is equal to 16, which is congruent to 1. And so we can calculate inverses using the extended Euclidean algorithm, which is implemented in the PyCrypto library in crypto.util.number.inverse. So now that we have the inverse of R mod n, we can calculate our blinded message. We should calculate b to the power d, which equals m times r e to the power d. And since e and d are the public and private keys of RSA encryption, we get m to the power d times r mod n. If we multiply by the inverse of r, we get md mod n. And if we apply the public exponent, we can get m. And the second way of solving this problem, first, take our random nonce to the power e, and we'll call that r. We're going to calculate the inverse of r. If we take our blinded message times the inverse of r, we get our message times re times r. Since re and capital R are inverses, they cancel, and we're left with just our message. Comparing the two ways, the second way is quicker. It only involves one exponentiation and one inverse, whereas the first way requires two exponentiations and one inverse. And here is my solution. In this first step, we calculate what I call capital R, big nonce. We use the inverse function from the PyCrypto library to calculate the inverse of our big nonce, modulus the our n value. We can then remove the nonce from our bill by multiplying the bill times the nonce inverse, again, modulus n, and returning. So in the verify function itself, we loop through all of the bills and nonces, remove the nonce, check the value, where message value does some conversions to change message, which is an integer, into bits, make sure the padding is right, and then convert the bits to a string, and then check the value of that string. We then see if the test value is equal to our target value. If it's not, return false, because we don't need to verify anymore. If we've passed all of these, return true.